Aloha everyone and welcome back. I hope you had a blessed week. Last week we had the opportunity to learn about Philip and the Ethiopian, and I hope that you guys were able to go out and share Jesus Christ with your family, your friends, community member. If so, I'd love to hear your story. So please send Auntie Powahi a video or a text message just sharing about how you stepped out in faith and shared Jesus Christ with someone you may or may not know. All right, we're gonna get ready for our new lesson of the week, and I can't wait to see what activity Auntie Lani has in store for us and the amazing message that Uncle Dwight has for us. So please stay tuned and I'll see you guys soon.
Hi everyone, it's Auntie Lani and this is our fourth week learning about the Holy Spirit. This week we're going to hear a story about how the Holy Spirit helped Peter to escape from prison. Are you ready for that? Uncle Dwight's ready for you, but before we do that, let's do our craft project. For this project, you will need 2 sheets of paper, scissors, a pencil to draw with, crayons or markers, or I have colored pencils, and glue or tape. All right, go get your supplies and I'll meet you right back here. got your supplies? All right. So the first thing we're going to do is draw Peter and the angel that came to set him free from the prison that he was in. On your first sheet of paper, we're going to start about a quarter of the way down. So if you want to fold your paper so you know where your drawing space is going to be. Oh, that's too little. Hold on. Auntie is readjusting her drawing space. And I changed to markers so that you could see the drawing a little better. So first we're going to draw Peter. And we're just going to make his face first by doing a rectangle. So we're going to start from the top, come down, make a little C. And then his chin on the bottom. And we're going to go back up and complete our triangle. Then for his hair, you can make his hair however you want. I'm gonna make his hair look curly with 1, 2, 3, and 4 big circles here. Then I'm gonna draw his nose. You're gonna start from the top of your triangle and you're gonna come down almost to the ear and make an L. You're going to come inside of that one and make another L with a circle at the end for his nose. And then we're going to draw his eyes. Just make a circle here and a circle here. Then we're going to color in our circle. Oh, my eyes. Funny. I ran out of space. Then you can make his mouth with a little smile. Okay, he's not sticking tongue. And then we're going to draw his arms. Just going to come down, pull back up, make a half circle. We're going to draw his other arm, and we're going to come down, go out, and meet up with the circle. That looks like, I don't know, a backward sword. Then we're going to draw his hand. And we're going to draw his other arm from this side. We're going to go out. Come back in and go down to make his robe. Then you can just draw his arm or his hand. I'm going to draw a little semi-circle looking line just to make it the closure of his robe and then his belt. Now we have his feet. You can draw his feet however you want. And I'm gonna put little circles for his robe. Okay, you got yours. Now we're going to draw the angel who came to rescue him. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to make a big rectangle. And then we're going to put a band for his headband. And we're going to make his hair. And it looks, I'm going to make it look, it looks like feathers. And then he has a little panel that comes out to the side. We need to make a little seed for his ears. And then we can draw his nose. Come down with an L. Draw another L and a circle. And then his eyes. His eye is going to be looking back at Peter because he's showing Peter the way out. Then we'll give him a little smile. And now we'll draw his arms. He's just drawing a line. And the line's coming back down. Then his robe. I'm gonna make his hand. Okay, and this arm is gonna come this way because it's walking out the door. I'm gonna be walking out the prison door. He's just drawing lines for his robe. And then his feet. Okay, I think that came out pretty good. Okay, so now, oh, Auntie forgot the hand. Don't forget to put his hand. Wow, that's a big hand. So if you want to color yours in, I normally don't like drawing with Sharpies, but Uncle Reynolds said I had to draw with a Sharpie. So I'm gonna give Peter some golden hair. I think I'm gonna make the angel's hair gold too. But you can color yours whatever color you would like. I'm gonna give the angel a blue headband. Oops. And I forgot about coloring in his ponytail. Guess he needs to have hair coming this way if he has a ponytail. This is hard to color with Sharpies. I'm sure you guys are doing a lot better with your coloring. I'm having a hard time. Goes with a red gown. Orange? I don't know. And she's gonna color it orange. That looks pretty cool. I don't have done you many colors to choose from. I don't know. Angel's robe blue, like his headband. Okay, you got your coloring done. Now we're gonna take our second sheet of paper. We're gonna fold it in half. And we're gonna cut it. Because this is going to be the prison bars. Because remember, Peter was in prison. And he wasn't in prison because he did something bad. He was put in prison because he was telling people about Jesus and where he came from, the king. And that city didn't want anybody talking about Jesus. Okay, so Auntie made a little fold on the top because that's what we're gonna glue down or tape down to our paper after we make our prison bars, okay? So unfold it. Then you're gonna take your paper, flip it over like this, and you're just going to make little folds like this, back and forth, okay? So just keep folding your paper. Can you see that? Just fold that back and forth, back and forth. So you get to the other side of the paper. Have to be perfect. So once you fold it, your paper should look like this. Like an accordion. Okay? Oops, fold it back up. This was a tricky part for me to learn. So what we're gonna do is you can do them all at one time if you want. If your scissors can do it all at one time, you can do them a little at a time, like maybe do three. But we are going to cut just a little bit off on these edges. So you can cut in a little. That back, and we're just going to cut a little bit of the edges. Can you see that? Just cut that up to the fold that we made that we were going to tape down. Oops, paper ran away. Snip it off. So I did three. And this next one, I'm just gonna do two of them. It took me a while to figure out how I could do this to make it look like the bars at a prison, in a prison cell. I'm sure you don't know what that looks like because you've probably never been in a prison before. If you need help, please ask your parent or an auntie or an uncle to help you, because it's okay to help and it's okay to do crafts together. Okay, Auntie finished putting hers all out. So we're going to spread it out. We're going to open it up. Okay, there. Okay, so we're going to fold that top piece down that we folded before. And we're going to tape it to our picture. Or you can glue, if you're gonna glue, you would put glue on this side and then glue it down like that. But I couldn't find my glue, so I am going to use tape. I grandma picture. Oh, Auntie stuck it in the wrong place. Didn't measure. See? It's okay to make a mistake. I went the wrong way, guys. It's a good thing this tape can come off and on and off. Hey, there. Okay, once you got your prison bars down, we're gonna write our Bible verse at the top of the page. Acts 1:8. Acts 1:8. And it says, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. So this is what our craft project should look like. Here's Peter in prison with the prison bars and the prison doors closed. And our verse says Acts 1:8. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Because Peter was doing what God was asking him to do, and he wasn't in prison for doing anything bad, God sent his Holy Spirit to come upon Peter, and the Holy Spirit sent an angel, and the prison doors flung open, and the angel showed Peter the way out. If you guys could only see Uncle Reynolds in the background trying to do the videotaping. I hope you had a great time today. I had fun. I've been having fun trying to learn to draw and to color better. I pray that this week you have an amazing week with your family, and most importantly, with God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. Have a great week. See you next week. Bye.
Slapstick Theater. Peter escapes from prison. This is Peter.
Heyo!
Who was one of Jesus' disciples.
Yep.
Peter told people about Jesus. There was a king named Herod who tried to stop anyone who tried to tell others about Jesus. He arrested Peter and took him to jail to be executed. While Peter was in prison, the people of the church prayed for him. The night before Peter was supposed to go to trial, he was sleeping. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord stood before him. The angel woke Peter up and said, "Quick, get up." The chains fell off Peter's wrists.
Whoa!
Then the angel told him to get up and get ready to go and to follow him. So Peter left the cell, but all the time he thought was happening wasn't real and that it was just a vision. They passed by the guards, and when they came to the iron gate, it opened for them on its own.
Wow, awesome!
They were walking through the street when the angel suddenly left him.
Wait, what just happened?
Peter finally realized that this was all really happening and that God had sent an angel to save him from what King Herod and the Jewish leaders had planned to do to him.
Wow!
He went to the home of Mary, where many believers were together praying. When Peter knocked at the door, a servant girl came to answer.
Hey, let me in! Peter!
When she realized it was Peter, she was so excited that she ran inside to tell people instead of letting Peter in.
I'm so honored.
It's Peter!
The people inside thought the girl was wrong and said, it must be Peter's angel. But Peter kept knocking. When the people finally opened the door, they were amazed. Peter told them about what happened and all about how God sent an angel to rescue him from prison.
Hi, kids. Uncle Dwight here again. Good to see you. Hope you had an amazing week. And so wasn't that a cool video about Peter where he was freed by God's angel from prison? So there was King Herod upset that Peter was preaching Jesus to the crowd and had him arrested and put into prison. But God sent his angel into prison and freed Peter. And much of it was because the church was praying for Peter's freedom. And sure enough, the angel came and got Peter out of prison. And he went to where they were gathered in prayer and surprised them that it was an answer to their prayer. And they were shocked to see Peter there. But, I think this story had three things that really stands out to me. One is that God's angels, throughout the Bible, God uses his angels, his servants, to go out and to help his people. And this story here is a great example where the angel was sent by God to rescue Peter out of prison and free him from behind locked bars and even a gate and open it up and got him out of prison. And God has angels that also watches over you, and you can call upon God for help, and he may be sending an angel to come to right where you're at times to help you out, whatever the circumstance might be. So, just amazing. The Bible says that you never know when you may be entertaining angels. That person who may have come to help you or assist you may have been an angel of God. So you just never know. But also, the power of prayer. God's people were gathered and concerned because there was Peter put into prison and likely getting into deeper trouble because Herod didn't want him preaching Jesus. And they prayed to God, and God answered the prayer, as he always does, and got Peter out of prison. So remember that prayer can do amazing things, right? Some things may seem impossible, like poor Peter locked up in prison by King Herod, but he was rescued and released and free. So you don't forget, you can always pray to God and ask him to help you, especially in a time of need. God hears your prayer. And then the last thing, in God's people at the end says we're amazed. And so you can see God loves to see you smile. He loves to see that when his people pray and reach out to him, that he is an amazing God. And he just wants to make you glorify him and say, wow, God, that was amazing. Just like the church did. They were shocked and amazed when Peter showed up at the front gate. Or at the door knocking, and the girl ran back to tell the rest of it, and they came out, and it says that they were just amazed and blown away. And God loves to do that many times, is to show you how mighty, how powerful, and how glorious he is. So anyway, just remember those things this week. Don't forget, God sends his angels to watch over you. There's power behind prayer, and God always looks for opportunities to amaze you. So don't forget those things. All right, well, until next time, may God bless your week, and I'll talk to you soon again. Bye-bye.